What's going on, everybody? Today we are doing the top five things that every lure painter or lure maker should have in their workspace. And really what this is just top five things that I use all the time. So I figured I'd share it with you guys and it might help some of you out. So let's get into it. So most of us that are painting our baits, if you're not selling them, you're at least showing them on social media, trying to take pictures of them, stuff like that. So first thing up is a little bit strange, but extremely helpful, and I've been using it since day one. And what that is a little kneaded eraser. If you've ever taken a drawing class, they stretch. And what I like to use this for is at the end of all my YouTube videos, I always show the bait finished. And then a lot of times I'll take a picture of the bait and post it on Instagram or Facebook or something like that, or even using it for my website. And it can be a pain to get the bait to sit just right for that shot. So what I like to use this for is you can peel off a little part of it, roll it up, and it's just tacky enough that it'll stick to the bait and to the table or the surface you have the bait leaned on. And it's just enough to hold that bait upright without leaving any sort of sticky residue. You can make really small pieces so it's easy to not get it in frame. So if you watch any of my videos, any final shots I have of the bait where it's propped up a certain way and there's nothing behind it, I'm using one of these guys. I've been using them since day one. So if you're having trouble getting your baits propped up while you're trying to photograph them or take video of them, I recommend these. Again, it's a kneaded eraser. I think even Walmart has them. They're like $3 or so. You can get two of these. They last a long time and you can erase stuff with it, so it doubles. In no particular order, number two on the list are these. You guys, I rave about these. You know it if you watch my videos. These are acid brushes. You can get these from Harbor Freight. I believe you get about 50 of them in a pack or so for $4, I think is about what it is. A couple things that I like to use these for. One, you get so many of them from really cheap, so it's a really good throwaway brush. Two, I'll cut them down a little bit shorter. That way the bristles are stiffer and I use them to do splatters on my fishing lures. I also use these to do the clear coating because it's just a good throwaway brush. It's cheap, holds quite a bit of clear coat in it whenever you're brushing it on. I do recommend though, if you're using these for clear coat, kind of rough up the tip a little bit and pull, and there'll be some little bristles you can pull out just because they are cheap brushes. That way you don't end up with a paint bristle in the clear coat of your finished bait. Also, I like to use these once I've used them for clear coat and the tip is all hard. I still use them to stir up like two-part epoxies or stir up a two-part clear coat, then throw them away. So you can actually get several uses out. So splatter work, mixing clear coat, mixing two-part epoxies for gluing in hardware, acid brushes, a whole bunch for real cheap. Highly recommend them, and I use them all the time. Number three on the list is kind of a runner-up to that. They go hand in hand together. Whenever you're doing clear coat or epoxies, you're always mixing them in some. And for the longest time, I didn't want to spend any money on anything, so I was using bottom of soda cans or a little piece of cardboard mixing up my glue. It'd become a pain. And I recently discovered these at Walmart. Super cheap. You get 50 of them. And what they are is it's just a little cup with a lid. So a couple of things that I've been using these for. One, the obvious, you're mixing up your clear coat. And then what I'll do is I'll take the lid, it's got this little indention in the top, and I'll mix up my two-part epoxy in there. So it kind of keeps it all contained in that one spot. And it's always a clean surface, and I don't really have a use for the lid, so it works great for that. The other plus with these is, one, you get your ratio figured out if you're doing any sort of two-part epoxies, and you can make the marks on the side of the can. Make it on all of them, that'll save you a little bit of time when you're mixing your clear coat. Another benefit with these is if you're mixing up a custom color of paint, it's not a good long-term storage, but it'll definitely keep your paint overnight or for the afternoon if you're mixing up a custom color. So works great for that. And a huge bonus with these, this is just a little extra one for you guys. If you put some barbecue sauce in there, you can eat it. You can eat some chicken nuggets while you're working on your fishing lure. Okay, on to number four. Number four is another Harbor Freight special, and it's just an organizing bin. So I used to have all my stencils and all my eyes all just tossed into one little tub, and it made it kind of a pain to keep them organized and to find the stuff quickly. What I use this one for, it actually normally sits right behind where the camera is on my desk. I've got all my different size hooks at the top, all my split rings, and 2.5 rows of different color of eyes. A really good way to keep them organized. Depending on how you collect your eyes for your baits, you can organize them by size or do it like I did, where I just did it by color. really good way, and I just pulled one off of each and stuck it on the outside so a quick glance I can see which one I'm looking for. I also keep things like the water slide transfer paper. I need to cut some more that says Baker Builds on it. I keep those in there. I also, just a good way to kind of organize different types of stencils. And I've got one drawer, yeah. This drawer is a whole bunch of pieces of cardstock I've cut out in different shapes and sizes. Keeps them all organized. The whole top of this thing, the front of it's covered in dust because it's been sitting there a while and it is in a wood shop. But everything that's inside the drawer stays dry. I believe you can get these for less than $15. I don't know for sure. It's been a while since I've looked at them. But really good way to keep everything within arm's reach and easy to get to and organized for rather cheap. Number five that is on the list is actually in my drawer. And it is, well, supposed to be in my drawer. Toothpicks. I don't have any toothpicks to show you guys. I hope you know what a toothpick looks like. I like using the toothpicks because whenever you're mixing paint in the cup of the airbrush, if I mix a couple different colors or add a little bit of black into something to make it darker, mix it up inside the cup, works great for that. Another thing that I love using toothpicks for is when I'm clear coating. So whether you're dipping a bait or you're brushing some sort of clear coat on, there's always going to be a little bit of clear coat that gets inside the eyelet of the bait. So I like using the toothpick to clear those out because it kind of absorbs that clear coat. So whenever you push it through the eyelet and pull it back out, it kind of absorbs into the wood. And if you're eating chicken nuggets, using those little cups and you know, toothpick. And we're gonna go ahead and throw a bonus in on this video. So number six, it's not really nothing special, but it is something that I use all the time, and that is Q-tips. A couple of things I use a Q-tips for is whenever you get paint built up in the end of your airbrush, I will put a little Windex on there, cleaning solution, something. Make sure when you do this, you pull your needle back. That way you're not crushing your needle. And you can just clean the tip of it out real nicely. And then also, of course, getting down in there and cleaning out the paint that's inside. Another thing I've used a Q-tip before is if I'm gluing in the eye on the bait and I get way too much glue on there, works real nice to grab a Q-tip real quick and it just kind of absorbs a lot of that glue, gets it off there so it doesn't run down the side of your bait and mess it up. Keeping those in my little bin in the same spot as always, so if I do need it in an emergency, I know right where it's at. So that is five things that I use every single time I'm working on painting baits or carving them. I have some couple other things I would like to do another video on. So there's something you guys use that you think should be in a top five video, make sure to comment below and let me know. Also, it might be something that I didn't know that would make my life easier. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you have a phenomenal 4th of July weekend celebrating our freedom. I will catch you guys later. Peace.